subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.
You're watching Tag TV.
India is well known around the world owing to its historical background, diverse cultures and interesting traditions. Its ancient scriptures and texts have been the way of life of its people for thousands of years. Today, the country is taking huge strides in various fields like arts and science, paving a way towards a progressive India. So friends, I'm your host Shreyasa Vijay, and today in our episode of My India, we'll take a look at some of the stories that very well showcase the unique culture and prosperity of our country, stretching from Himalayas to Kanyakumari. Being an agrarian society, India celebrates a number of harvest festivals. These festivals are an integral part of the country's cultural legacy, and over the centuries, they have evolved in various forms. So, today in our episode of My India, we'll take you to the eastern state of Odisha to witness Nuakhai, which was recently celebrated in a somber way amid the worldwide pandemic.
Food is considered sacred in India. The country celebrates a variety of festivals to offer their prayers to gods for blessing them with a good harvest season and abundant produce. Nuakhai, observed in parts of western Odisha and southern Chhattisgarh, is one such festival that marks the new season of rice. Though every year the festival is celebrated with great pomp and show, but this year, due to the worldwide pandemic, the celebrations were kept a low-key affair, with citizens observing it at their homes instead of thronging the temples.
This time the monsoon has kind enough. Right now the things are going in the right direction. And due to this pandemic situation of COVID-19, though it has not been celebrated widely, but every household they celebrate in their home, and it's the rich culture of our state.
Also known as Nabana and Nuakhai, in some parts of Odisha, the three-day festival is a symbol of gratitude towards the god for blessing the citizens with good rain, favorable weather and lavish produce. Celebrated on the Panchami Tithi of Krishna Paksh of Bhadra month of Hindu calendar, preparations for the festival begins before a fortnight, which includes cleaning the house and buying new clothes. The festival breaks all caste and economic barriers and brings all citizens closer to each other, as they all unite to celebrate the welcoming of new harvest.
पवित्र नुआखाई आउ एई दिन समस्ते आबाड़ वृद्ध बनिता सकाळ नित्यकर्म सारी सर्वप्रथम निजर जार जार खेत अच्छे समस्त खेत के जाई करी समस्ते निजर जमीन पूजा पाठ करी करी नुआ धान आनी करी समस्ते आगे दियो देवता मन के लगे करी तापर नुआखाई जैसी.
As the word Nua means new and Khai means food, the festival Nuakhai revolves around food and the celebrations of healthy harvest. It celebrates the farmer's possession of newly harvested rice. Devotees cook relishes from the first produce of the season also which is served as a religious offering or prasad to the respective deities. It is further distributed to the entire family and is consumed by a priest. Various traditional dishes and sweets like rasbhara, suji mada and kheeri are prepared on the occasion, and this year, because of the pandemic, families enjoyed the meals at their homes and took the blessings of the elders, priest and the Almighty. The festival has a big significance for farmers and agricultural community, and also celebrates the renewal of mutual ties that spread warmth all around and binds the communities together in a spirit of solidarity.
When it comes to celebrating festivals in India, the differences of caste and faith gets diluted, and people come together to create a strong bond of humanity. The same can be witnessed amidst the celebrations of Ganesh Chaturthi, when people cutting across religious lines are showcasing their indulgence in the festivities. One among them is a Sikh restaurator from Ludhiana city in Punjab, whose chocolate Ganesha is winning hearts.
For a fifth year in a row, a Sikh restaurator and chocolatier in Ludhiana has prepared an edible Ganpati idol with pure dark Belgian chocolate to celebrate the festival of Ganesh Chaturthi. Though a Hindu festival and not so popular in Punjab, Harjinder Singh Kakareja has been displaying this work of art for the last 4 years to give a message of communal harmony and eco-friendly festivities. This year, 40 kgs of chocolate Ganesha was prepared in Kakareja's restaurant by 10 chefs in 10 days.
We do it to promote the message of eco-friendly Ganeshas. It's very important that we don't pollute our water bodies, and yet we celebrate our festivals. Because of coronavirus, we have reduced the size of our celebrations. Last year we made 80 kgs of chocolate Ganesha, this year we made 40 kgs. But we wanted to make sure that we continue the celebration and not stop by the coronavirus amid the pandemic. So I think it's important that we find a middle path and not end our celebrations and everything. Yeah, the whole idea is to celebrate the festival in a way that it benefits the environment.
This chocolate Ganesha is not just created for vanity, but has a noble cause to serve. It will be immersed in milk, and that chocolate milk will be further distributed among the underprivileged children. Though every year Kakareja himself distributes the milk, but this year, due to the pandemic, he took help of NGOs for the same.
We do visarjan in milk, and we distribute the chocolate milk to poor children. And we do it personally, we go ourselves and do it. But this year, because of coronavirus, we are tying up with some organizations which were serving poor people during the lockdown. So what we will do is, we will take the chocolate milk and we'll give it to those organizations who served people during the lockdown, and they will do it on behalf of us.
Needless to say, people across the country were gobsmacked by the initiative of a Sikh restaurator, as it not only promotes environment conservation but also carries a beautiful message of unity enveloped in creativity.
Now, a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently.
After battling for electricity for decades, a village in Shopian district of Jammu and Kashmir got its first power receiving station. Residents of the village were earlier facing many problems due to non-availability of power supply, as in these areas there was no receiving station. The village is located at a height of about 2,146 meters above sea level, which makes it a difficult terrain to lay the transmission lines.
इस रिसीविंग स्टेशन की अहमियत बहुत ज़्यादा है हमारे ज़िले के लिए, क्योंकि ये कैलर हिली तहसील को केटर करता है, जहाँ पे बहुत ही बैकवर्ड्स और फारफेच्ड रिमोट विलेजेस हैं, काफ़ी जो अभी तक डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन नेटवर्क से कनेक्टेड भी नहीं हैं और जो काफ़ी अरसे से स्नो बाउंड भी रहते हैं सर्दियों में. इसमें तकरीबन 25 ऐसे गांव हैं जो बेनिफिट होंगे और काफ़ी बड़ी और गरीब आबादी होगी जो इसका फ़ायदा ले पाएगी.
The receiving station with a 6.3 megavolt ampere transformer has been constructed by Sub-Transmission Division of Power Development Department at the cost of Rs. 3.4 crore.
Baldeep Ningthojam, a class 9 student from Imphal, has developed a mobile game Koroboi based on COVID-19 details, which is now available for Android users. As per the description of the app on Google Play Store, Koroboi, a boy from Manipur is stranded and wants to return home. Wearing Manipuri traditional cloth and a mask, he will run towards his goal. He will be earning points during his journey. If the police caught him, a fine of 5,000 points will be deducted. Ningthojam wants to become an ethical hacker and learn more about artificial intelligence and other technologies.
Researchers at Indian Institute of Science, in collaboration with the country's space agency, ISRO, have created space bricks which have the potential to build structures on lunar surface in an affordable and eco-friendly manner. The researchers have developed a sustainable biological process with a combination of lunar soil simulant, bacteria and guar beans gum that can be used as load-bearing structures on the moon and other extraterrestrial surfaces.
We know that other space agencies have expressed a desire where they want to send astronauts for longer and longer missions, and where they want the astronauts to stay for very long durations and be able to conduct various experiments, or maybe even do space mining on the moon and Mars. So in order to do that, you will need to build structures for them where they will be able to stay. So we hope that our discovery and our work is going to help them.
The cost of sending 1 pound of material to outer space is about 7,50,000 rupees. India has developed a reputation for pioneering affordable satellite launches and space missions. Its unmanned Mars mission in 2014 cost just $74 million, less than the budget of the Hollywood space blockbuster Gravity.
A hospital in Pune city of Maharashtra kicked off human trials for the potential COVID-19 vaccine to develop a response to the virus which has infected over 3.2 million people in India. The vaccine candidate, developed in Oxford University and manufactured at the Serum Institute of India, gave the first doses to two volunteers who tested negative for COVID-19 and antibodies in the city's Bharti Vidyapeeth Hospital. Doctors said the two volunteers will be under observation for a week and have been asked to report to the hospital on peculiar symptoms.
And out of the five candidates, three had antibodies, so they were not eligible to take vaccine, and two who were negative for both, they have been given the vaccine. Both are males. After giving the vaccine, after half an hour, if their vitals are stable, they will be going home.
They will explain few things which they have to observe and report to us on our emergency numbers.
Potential vaccines are undergoing trials in a number of different countries, including India, Britain, Russia, and China, as scientists have raced to unpick the secrets of a virus that emerged less than a year ago. A short film based on lockdown titled Abhilash, which sends out a message of awareness during the COVID-19 lockdown, has bagged an international award at the Bengal Lockdown Online Film Festival in the Best Social Message Film category. Shot in and around Hinjili Kattu area of Behrampur in Ganjam district of Odisha, Abhilash has been directed by Guru Krishna Chandra Sahu. The short film essays the story of a poverty-stricken boy who keeps himself safe amid the coronavirus lockdown and reads messages of social distancing. The International Film Festival that was organized under the supervision of organizer Subham Poof witnessed contests from around 135 films around the world. Out of these, only 50 from 20 countries were officially nominated.
India is a country where different communities have coexisted peacefully for centuries. And even today, they continue to live in complete harmony. Numerous stories that can elaborate this fact can be found across the country. The recent one to make headlines is a heartwarming incident from Maharashtra's Ahmednagar, where a Muslim man helped in organizing the wedding of two Hindu sisters.
With no male member to perform the rituals in the weddings of two Hindu sisters, Gauri and Savri, a Muslim man, Baba Bhai Pathan, stood in from the bride's side in Bodhegaon village of Ahmednagar. He not just participated in the wedding, but also helped in organizing it. As per the sources, the father of the brides is estranged and their mother, Savita Bhusari, is Pathan's Rakhi sister, and both of them consider him as their uncle. And it's due to this beautiful bond among them that he came up to perform the Hindu ritual of Kanyadan, where a patriarch from the bride's side gives away the bride to the groom.
काल जे माझे आतून दोन मुलींचं जे कन्यादान झालंय ते पहिलीपासून त्यांचे आणि माझे घरच्यांचे जवळजवळ 25-30 वर्षापासून संबंध आहेत आणि माझं आणि त्यांचं घर समोरासमोर आहे आणि ते पहिल्यापासून लहानपणापासून आतापर्यंत मला ते दोन्ही मुली मामा म्हणून समजतात आणि माझी जी गुरु बहीण आहे ती पहिल्यापासून मला लहानपणापासून राखी बांधते कारण की हे राखीचं जे नातं आहे हे राखीचं नातं एकदम घट्ट करण्यासाठी आणि मामाची भूमिका बजावण्यासाठी आमच्या गुरु बहिणीला सक्क भावना असल्यामुळं माझ्या बहिणीने मला सांगितलं की तूच आमचा पहिल्यापासून आम्ही तुला भाव मानतो आणि पोरी पण तुला पहिल्यापासून मामा मानतात की हे जे पवित्र कार्य आहे लग्नाचं हे तुला पार पाडावं लागणं त्यांच्या मागणीला मी नवरीचा मामा म्हणून आणि कन्यादान म्हणून मी माझं पवित्र कार्य पार केलं आहे.
Ever since this incident has come into limelight, Pathan is being widely praised across the country. Netizens too have expressed their love and affection towards Pathan and reiterated the constant need of such cordiality between people irrespective of beliefs and faith. The mother of the brides is also effusive in praises of her brother Pathan, who has helped her in every situation.
माझ्या मुलींचे दोन्ही मुलींचे काल विवाह पार पडले. त्यांच्या पाठी माझा बाबा पठाणचा नात आहे. बाबा पठाण माझे मानलेले होऊ दे रक्ताच्या नात्यापेक्षा त्यांनी त्यांचं कर्तव्य एवढं मोठं निभावलं ते मी कधीच विसरू शकत नाही. 20 वर्षापासून त्यांचा हात माझ्या डॉक्टर जब माझे वडील एक्सपायर झाले बंधू झाले तरी बाबा पठाणचा हात माझ्या डॉक्टर होता. शेवटी मुलीच्या कार्यात मला खूप अडचणी आहे पण बाबा पठाण कोणाचा विचार न करता माझ्या डॉक्टर हात घेऊन माझ्या मुलीचे कन्यादान केले.
Examples like Pathan are truly an inspiration to rise above the religious biases and make our society a better place to live.
Doing easily what others find difficult is talent, but doing something that others find impossible is genius. India is home to the first female mathematical prodigy, Shakuntala Devi, who was able to calculate much faster than the computer. Next in line is the fastest human calculator, who has recently won the first ever gold for the country at the Mental Calculation World Championship.
What Usain Bolt is to running, Michael Jordan is to basketball, and Garry Kasparov is to chess. India's Neelkanth Bhanu Prakash is to world of mathematics. Based in Hyderabad, Bhanu Prakash has recently bagged the title of fastest human calculator after winning the first ever gold medal in the Mental Calculation World Championship at Mind Sports Olympiad held in London recently.
In the last 15 years of my journey, I've won multiple national championships, multiple international championships, and have represented India in Mental Calculation World Cups across the world. Having done events and stage shows across 23 countries, I would say that I have done my bit to talk about and place India on the global level.
A student of St. Stephen's College of Delhi University, Bhanu Prakash has achieved this glory at a tender age of 20. But he puts his success down to his preparations, and he feels that he wasn't a born genius. As a child, Bhanu used to practice mathematics 6 to 7 hours outside his school, which has made him efficient in this art. Bhanu's aim goes beyond winning laurels and breaking world records. He wants to eradicate maths phobia from the society because he feels that some people are afraid of numbers. He also has a venture named Exploring Infinities, where he works for the same. Not just his parents and locals, but the entire country is proud of his endeavors.
We are very happy because all these years, since 15 years, he is putting a lot of efforts apart from his regular education. We were literally with him throughout this achievement, and today he reached a stage where the entire country is proud of his achievement, and winning a gold medal in the Olympics in the mental sport, that is in the mathematics, is something, a really great achievement for him.
Besides being the first non-European to win the Mental Calculation World Championship, Bhanu has several accolades to his name. With his hard work and determination, Bhanu has not just brought laurels to the country, but has also registered his name in the list of math maestros like Shakuntala Devi and Scott Plensberg. He aspires to make Telangana the state with highest mathematical literacy levels in the country.
That's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at myindia@anin.com. I'm your host, Shreya Savichai, and it's goodbye from the entire production team.